So this video is going to give an insight into what many of you might have heard of as CARA. So Devin, can I ask you the first question? What is CARA?
Absolutely. So CARA is an acronym. It means Common Audit Report Application.
Okay. And why is IATF introducing this now? Niall, can you give us an insight as to why we're talking now about this common application?
We could talk for hours about this, but obviously there are currently 41 IATF approved certification bodies, and each one of those certification bodies will have their own audit reporting format. IATF stipulate the content of the audit report in the rules document, but the way that translates is different across every certification body. The requirement is the same, but their own format for reporting it will be different. And I guess there's a number of factors that have led to the IATF deciding that they needed one common audit reporting format. And that's a combination of factors. Large organizations sometimes use multiple certification bodies. The people within those organizations are presented with audit reports from different certification bodies. So there's an element of understanding the structure and content of the report, whereas it would have been maybe better if there was just one format such that it could be easily and quickly understood. Other people outside of the organization being audited might request access to an audit report. They may be an IATF OEM, or it might be during an IATF office assessment. And again, it's really helpful to just have one approach to the audit report. I think for the clients as well, it's useful for them just to know that this is the format of an audit report. And I think for the auditors, so I think there are benefits for everyone. And some people would say this is sort of 20 years too late. But I always say better late than never.
Yeah, and it's always easy looking back in hindsight, but let's look forward then. So we are going to see this common approach to audit reporting. It's a major project. Devin, what's the timescale for implementation?
We are expecting that the certification bodies and auditors implement this in January of 2021.
Okay, and I think some pilots from what I've seen have already started in some certification bodies.
There are certification bodies that are already using the CARA.
Mm-hmm. What about the time to complete the report? Is this going to take auditors any more time to complete the report?
Now, again, there's functionality within CARA that allows some information to be imported from existing systems to give a head start in terms of completing the audit report. But equally, there are portions of CARA that must be completed by the auditor during the on-site audit. The rules have changed, so there will be a sanction interpretation that has been issued that extends the maximum audit reporting time from 10% of the audit time to 15%. So the IATF are granting additional time to be dedicated to reporting the audit. But again, it's worth just reiterating the concept of writing an audit report is not new. All we're doing is introducing a common application for the auditors to use. And again, there will be training rolled out through the CARA wiki page to all of the IATF auditors globally.
Yeah, and Devin, a technical question. Will auditors need access to the internet to complete the report?
At some point, they will have to have access to the internet, but they can fill out the form offline. It'll be stored within their recent history in their web browser.
Okay, so let's summarize then. So IATF have implementing a project with the 41 approved IATF certification bodies to implement what is being called CARA, the Common Audit Report Application. The timetable for implementation is January 2021. So organizations are going to be seeing what may look a slightly different structured report to what they are seeing now. But the overall content of the report should be fairly similar to what they've been seeing since the IATF 16949 scheme was designed 20 years ago. But the layout and format may look slightly different.